Good evening, everyone. So, although last year means this year they have asked question on NHRC, and I guess 2017 also they ask a question. So. Read. Less possibility it may be asked this year. If you talk from examination perspective. But still, since 25 years, so there is a formality to deal the topic. So you can take in that way. Or it is relevant, this is how I can say that, okay. Knowledge is always relevant. So, from that perspective, you can see. This year they asked a question which was a bit out of box question. Out of box means ki they wanted to merge similar human rights organizations into one. So, it was out of box because it was not in any general debate. So that kind of debate was not either in news, etc. Although you may have, some people may claim ki they knew, they had debate, etc. But it was a bit out of box, you can say that ki question. And there are many ways to ask questions still on NHRC. Anyhow, the basics you know will not be discussing, so you know about its creation. So basics you should know, creation, power, functions. If you know the basics clearly, then let's say that we will be able to evaluate of 25 years. Before that, just for your institutional memory, that NHRC was termed as toothless tiger by its own head. So NHRC has been termed, if you take some, before we evaluate, so already it is considered as a toothless tiger. Which people write, when they write any question on NHRC, necessarily they write this sentence. Right. The context may be relevant, may not be relevant, but they will write necessarily this. And since they think that they have written a very lofty thing about NHRC, therefore they will not write other weaknesses which are relevant. Right. So other, let's say that substantial aspect. Basically, people do not write. They think that it will take care of. That is the weakness when they write. It's again, we'll continue what we told in past class. It is not that you do not know the topic. It is about how you write that answer. That is how. So they don't write the substantial weaknesses. They think that toothless tiger, which is very extreme. The criticism is very extreme, which has been told. Another people say that it is recommendatory. You do say that it is recommendatory. Right. Another weakness is people talk is institutional aspect. Institutional capacity that we say that. And institutional capacity can include its finance. Its expertise. Right. This is all. And then finally we say that it can take only 1 year. 1 year old cases. So that is how we say as weakness. Which you know, basics also you know, so what we should evaluate of 25 years. Now, whether it has any positive things. Before we evaluate or write, this is how largely we write in terms of weakness. But do you have positive aspects? What NHRC has done? Right. If you write 25 years the same, I think, and the positive, so what we can write? Now let's say that positives can be basically you write factuals. Again, substance part is not written. Factuals ki you can give some examples of positive work. No. So factuals that you can give some examples of positive works. So what example you can take? Any example you will give, it will fit into NHRC. Right. So it can be related to mental hospital and people. It can be related to widows. It can be related to prisons, fake encounter, or it can be related to some riots, or it can be related to some raid. Other, any other? Right. Child rights, women rights. This is how you can give some examples. But what we can write on substance? Substance. What can be written? So, what grade can write on this? Substance is that it has helped create awareness about human rights. Right. So, it has been able to build a good social and psychological infrastructure, awareness, concern, about human rights in the country. So its efforts have resulted into in administration, in government, taking some steps, some policy, laws, reviews have been done to bring changes and protect human rights. That will be on substance part, let's say that. So in 25 years, it will create certain awareness, deterrence, research, conference, education on human rights. That people today have knowledge that there is a National Human Rights Commission, and investigating agencies, organizations do have in mind that human right will ask a question, means human right organization will ask some questions. So that level of at least, let's say, deterrence or checks have been created by NHRC. That is how we can write on when we write the substance part. That is how we can say. Now, are we missing something in analysis? So, still let's say that if it is asked what more should be done? What more we can do? But that's not the point. If I write a question, which we have asked, let's say that, NHRC, you can write this question. So NHRC has emerged as, it is not given in cash question. Some things should not be given. So NHRC has emerged as watchdog of protection of human rights. NHRC has emerged watchdog of protection of human rights. Protection of human rights in Indian democracy. in the last 25 years. In the last 25 years. Do you agree? Do you agree? Justify your view. Somebody has written in terms of was talk. Now the question will be again, let's say that if it is asked to write, I will not ask the to write answer, but the question is that if it is asked to write this question, so again the difference will be that it's not you know, people know it, right? But whether people will agree, can we say it has emerged as watchdog? Yes or no? Yes. Read. What in yes we will write? When we write yes, so what we will write? Yes. What will write in yes? No. Tell justification, 4 points. Tell 4 points. Mujhe pata hai, everyone knows human right. No, means human right commission, you know it. Lakshmikant kai bar padha hoga aapne. Right. Tell 4 points for justification. Yes. Government does.
Sir, government is considering for prison reforms.
Right. Yes. Let me say that you should not try to always find success of an institution by some quantitative performance. Right. This you should know. Since you will find some quantitative performance and then you will say that it is success. Since you do not find some very clear quantitative aspect, you think it is not. Right. But you should know that these are all steps taken. Right. Many steps have been taken. It may be that in fake encounter it is not. It may be that in disturbed area it is not. It may be that on prominent cases it is not. Controversial cases it is not. But in day-to-day basis there are many such issues on which steps have been taken. Right. You should know that in Vrindavan for widows there were steps. You should know that NHRC has, with all the mental hospital, a network it has established. And it monitors and supervises. You know that HIV/AIDS people have got their right to work without discrimination at its intervention. Right. So many necessary steps have been taken, let's say prison reforms also for protection of human rights. Right. So police, yes, there is fake encounter, lockup, torture, etc. But level of torture will certainly may have reduced. Right. You cannot say that police today still behave in the same fashion it used to behave 50 years back, 30 years back. So that is how you have to articulate, right? That will be the justification. Right. And this is how, let's say that in a society, how you will justify in a society which has all those diverse factors not to respect human rights? Right. It is a society which has all those diverse reasons not to respect human rights. Right. It is caste and cultural conflict. It is caste and cultural superiority. It is religious superiority. Right. That we have low level of awareness. Right. Lots of social, other such issues in our society. Right. And a colonial past. So in that environment, if you create any such institution, so it cannot experience success. Right. In a very crystal clear way, it will struggle to have success. Right. This you have to see also. It faces lots of constraints and challenges not created by this institution. Right. So the ecosystem in which it operates, that is very challenging. Right. Ours is a culture where hardly you have respect for others' rights. We have a very huge respect for ours' rights. But we don't have the respect for others' rights. Right. And therefore it functions in a less legitimate environment. It does not function in a very legitimate environment. It functions in a less legitimate environment. Right. And in that situation, if steps are taken, it is very encouraging. It is very appreciative. That is how you have to write in justification. Right. So these are the things can be written when you write evaluation part. Right. Means when you talk, and you should agree that it has emerged as a watchdog, although the level of expectation and satisfaction will always remain high. And in that pattern, it is still, let's say that, not satisfactory. That is how you should answer, you should write it. But that's not the point. Then let's say that government has tabled some amendments, right, in NHRC law. So it has tabled one amendment, you should note some provisions of that amendment, that is how it is. And second thing is that there are some other things that you should know. NHRC has some other, let's say that weak side, we did not mention. These are general weaknesses. But there are also problems associated with NHRC functioning. It itself as an institution has not functioned as effectively, even if it has power. Right. So what question we asked, let's say 2 years back, right. NHRC lacks the activism of other similar institutions. Can we say? NHRC lacks the activism of other similar institutions like CVC, like CIC, right, and other, let's say, constitutional bodies. Means NHRC, although it is criticized, it criticized itself for lack of power, but even the power which it enjoys has not exercised to fullest. Can we say? So you have to look into past issues. Right, the past issues are related with two important issues. One was Kairana and K-A-I-R-A-N-A, Kairana. And another was Chhattisgarh police gang rape case. Right. 2016. So we had, if you remember it, if you study them, so it was criticized that it was the same period when its head, right, so said that ki NHRC is a toothless tiger. In Kairana, they did not do proper research. It was a telephonic research, right. Telephonic research means ki they had a sample, they called some people, right. And some people, it is said even ki only one person has received that call. Means only one person picked up the call. So its research wing had a telephonic call, and on the basis of that telephonic call, they came to the conclusion that ki there was exodus of Hindus from Kairana, which was sharply criticized in media that ki did not do proper research. Let's say NHRC has a very high stature, and when it has a high stature, so that kind of, let's say that key view was not expected from NHRC. It must have done proper research analysis, Right, and then it could have given a view or published a view. Similarly, let's say that on Chhattisgarh police gang rape case of tribal women, it did not, let's say that, try for filing of FIR. Means it did not ask the police to file FIR. It did not ask the police to carry out investigation. It can ask. It depends on police whether they will file FIR, they will not file FIR. It depends on state whether they will carry investigation, they will not carry investigation. But when NHRC will ask, certainly, let's say that it will have certain rate, influence, certain impact. But even it did not ask for investigation. And let's say that case, those women could have got compensation. And that compensation, NHRC may have invoked the Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribe law, as under diet law, there is a higher compensation. And under NHRC law, there is a less compensation. The two laws were analyzed that time. So under NHRC law, they will get less compensation. Under the Scheduled Caste, Scheduled Tribe law, they will get more compensation. That power also NHRC did not invoke. And NHRC was talking to pay compensation, not to take legal action against those who committed that heinous crime. That is how, let's say, there are certain instances where NHRC itself, that time it was asked that whether NHRC is able to exercise its own power which it had enjoyed, and why it cannot act like the way other institutions have activism. This is how it is one way. So that is how, let's say, that weaknesses when you write, generally people write as if it is recommendatory, it cannot take suo motu, it can take suo motu action, but it is recommendatory, it cannot, let's say, punish, it does not have penal power. So does it mean it should get all such power to become effective? So this we can say that. What should be then? Government, first thing is that government needs to create a positive ecosystem, a supportive ecosystem. And it is the duty of the government, it is not the duty of NHRC. Because NHRC, when it will create a supportive environment, it will be limited. But when government creates a supportive environment, it will be far and wide. Means, let's say that within government you should have this, that you need to create supportive environment. Means the government institutions should be very clearly told that, you see, your rights, motivation, morale are important, no doubt, but at the same time human rights are also important. Human rights are also important. And this will not be compromised. So it depends on the government to create, and you will find that there is a glaring level of low concern in human rights, in government organization about human rights. And we don't have still the system to punish people for human rights violations. For instance, in Rayan International School case, I keep saying these examples. In Rayan International School case, the bus conductor Walla was arrested and beaten very badly. You know that when police arrests, what it does? He was a completely innocent person, which was, let's say that, released after some time, but after badly beating it. Tomorrow you will also become part of the same administration. And you will have the other view, not the view today you are talking about. So, because you become part of the establishment. Anyhow, still we'll tell it. So, the question is that he was beaten. Can you, let's say that, agar wo, suppose the same person is educated, highly educated, he will petition in the court. Right. Although still you will have to establish some precedent in this regard that the court will also become exemplary and give a punishment. Generally, they will not give a punishment in such cases exemplary because they have to see the institution, let's say that key, police also role. Otherwise, police will not become very, let's say that key, courageous, and they will not try to investigate and arrest people on the basis of certain suspicion. But the question is that certainly, let's say that it is not a case where police must have first arrested that person. This you should know that. So there can be similar such cases where you find that arrests are made, they are beaten badly, after some time they are released. Many people are falsely implicated and after some time they are released. What NHRC can do in this? NHRC can do nothing. And then we'll say it is failure of NHRC. Similarly, let's say that the lockup deaths happened. Who has made encounter policy? State has made. What NHRC can do in that? When state itself has an encounter policy, the role of NHRC is very limited. It can only write some good letters with good punctuation to state. Because state has made its own encounter policy and state would not like that any negative of the policy should come in media. It will like to show that the policy is a success. This is how. This is it, let's say that the second important aspect. State itself has a policy of encounter. And we feel, let's say that, proud of that. And encounter, etc., killing, that happens. So this is how, let's say, it is the second important aspect. State itself is responsible for that. State itself bar, let's say, human right in disturbed areas. You can have Unlawful Prevention Act, or you can have an Armed Forces Special Power Act. You can have, let's say, that key, other such laws where, let's say, role of NHRC is very limited. So that is how I was saying that the state itself has the responsibility to play a positive role rather than a neutral or negative role. This second thing is that you should not talk more at national level. First, you should start talk at a state level. What we are doing at a state level, State Human Rights Commission. Have you heard ever Punjab State Human Rights Commission, Haryana State Human Rights Commission, Uttar Pradesh Human Rights Commission, or let's say West Bengal Human Rights Commission has ever taken any step, any in media, news, etc.? It means they are just eating samosa, coffee, tea they are taking and just, let's say that, wasting the public resources. Sorry to say, this I keep saying. तो ठीक है साउथ इंडिया में इडली खाते होंगे नॉर्थ इंडिया में समोसा खा रहे होंगे बट द क्वेश्चन इज दैट कि दे हैव नो एनी वर्क दिस इज हाउ एंड देन द एंटायर बॉडी इन कम ऑन एनएचआरसी सो स्टेट ह्यूमन राइट कमीशन आर नॉट फंक्शनिंग दे आर डिफंक्ट सो बर्डन कम्स टू एनएचआरसी This is another important point. Second, NHRC should have expertise, body of expert. It will have members having expertise in human rights. So therefore, its members should be from different walk of life. But majority of members are ex-bureaucrats. Those who have destroyed human rights, they are protecting human rights. Sorry to say that. Bureaucrats. Bureaucrats are, let's say that its member, retired bureaucrats. Why bureaucrats are appointed? Although they can say they have all experiences. The question is that people having expertise in the field of human rights from different walk of life you need to bring with a record of, let's say, integrity, probity. This is how. That has also not been done. It should get adequate infrastructure. It should get adequate infrastructure, technology, and it should have its own machineries. Machinery means it should have its own staff rather than on the basis of deputation. Right. But you have deputation based, let's say, functionaries, they will serve for some period, they will go back. I was talking basics. The basics, this is how you should know that institutionally it should be strong, any institution should be institutionally strong. And that demand finance, expertise and its own functionaries. And that is how you have created national level of institution without having adequate capacity to function, even if it has to work on the behalf of the states. This. And then the question comes, acceptance of recommendations. Right. Government, let's say that, must accept the recommendations given by NHRC. Although there is a time period to accept, then there is also a provision that the government must respond with why it is not accepting. Now, it is a member, another NHRC member, let's say, statement. Government has mastered how to reply on the recommendations of NHRC. Why they are not accepting. Right. Since bureaucracies, that's why Babu Log, right, they have lots of expertise to write it. So these things can be written. And you need to change these things if you want to make it more effective. Otherwise, it will keep functioning the way it is. Right. We don't need to talk, it gives more power. We don't need to talk. Yes, what things, what more NHRC can be given? What powers can be given? Right. Can it have more powers? Right. This is how. So as far as powers are concerned, let's say that some major aspects, you don't have to write anything more. It should get more power. Right. Rather, it should be institutionally strong. If it is institutionally strong, if you accept its recommendation, that is its power. Right. Already it has suo motu power to carry out investigation. It has power to intervene meanwhile of the case and investigate it. It has power to take the case to the court also. It draw the attention of the court. It has also happened. Right. Already it has, let's say, that power, and 1 year criteria is not a major issue that it should be reviewed. Right. Yes, there should be a greater transparency in appointment of the members of NHRC. This can be said. There should be greater transparency in appointment of the members of NHRC. This we can say, and there can be, let's say that, although isme bhi koi dam nahi hai, but hame bolna padega formality ke liye. Right. Special courts should be there, human right courts. The special human right courts, right, courts to function nahi karta hai, the special kya function karega, but for the sake of point you can write. Right. The special human right courts, so that ki human right violation cases can be tried in a speedy manner, the way you have other designated special courts or special courts under other such law. So for human right violation also there should be special courts. Right. Human right special courts, this is how we say it. Right. Another thing can be told that there should be debate and discussion on its annual reports presented to parliament. Right. So that they can, this is how can say it should come from government, but do you think they will ever debate and discuss NHRC report? Right. So legislature, agar legislature puchhega NHRC se, tell us what is your report of 1 year, what you have done in 1 year, it will start functioning. Right, accountability, and you will give power also, but legislature hardly it has asked in 25 years. Right, this is how it is. This is how you have to create checks and balances, the system, proper checks and balances for its working. Rather than ki just give, let's say, explicit powers, right, that should not be recommended. By the way, law has been amended, means bill has been introduced, which is a kind of, you can say, progressive for the sake of qualifying this examination. Right. So they will reduce, instead of 5-year tenures, they will have 3-year tenures. 70 years or 5 years, this is how we say. So they will reduce the tenure from 5 years to 3 years, so that you can have more manipulation. That point should not be written. So 5 years to 3 years, this is one. Right. There is one, let's say, executive secretary, but there will be two such. Right. So there will be two IAS officers, not one. Right. So this they have done. Second, not only Chief Justice. Right. Even a Supreme Court judge can also become NHRC chairman. Right. So that is how the amendment bills, let's say that, brought, which does not address the important issues of NHRC. Rather, reducing the 3-year is a short tenure. And there is no rationale, because most of the institutions like that enjoy 5 years of tenure. Even CVC has a 4 years tenure. Right. But it is being given as 3 years tenure. इसीलिए तुक्का चलता है, sorry to say that. कोई rationale नहीं है कि 3 years क्यों है, 4 years क्यों है, 5 years क्यों है, 7 years क्यों है. कोई rationale होगा तो PT में आसानी होगा याद करना. Right. So the question is that this is how you will find it, there is no any rationale for 3 years. Right. Rather, if you have a member for 5 years, it gives stability, it gives leadership. Right. Many a time pursuing a case takes its own time. Right. But that is how it has not been done. Right. There should have been greater transparency, means let's say there should be more members. As of now, there is a domination of government in appointment. So you can have, let's say, that members from also leader of opposition, at least from leader of opposition in Rajya Sabha, also leader of opposition in Lok Sabha. So composition may have been also reviewed, right? And you need to have, means you should have defined also qualification of other members, right? Other members, chairman, it is understood ki he is a judge, but what about other members? So you could have some qualification defined, so that you can identify. So that has also not been done. Rather, let's say some amendments have been done to, let's say, simple, let's say, United Nations Human Rights Council to fulfill the obligation. By the way, United Nations Human Rights Council did not rate NHRC as a very efficient and independent functioning institution. You should know that peer audit of CAG is rated as a very good functioning institutions, but United Nations Human Rights Council has not rated NHRC as an independent functioning institution. Right. So this is how, let's say, that you can write some points. Still, on the whole, let's say that given the nature of Indian society, issues, problems, challenges, negative environment, all these things, still you should appreciate the functioning of NHRC. That is how we can tell on this aspect.